America, quite frankly, of all women in the United States of America, because many of our experiences are similar. And they all start out with us all being girls, first and foremost, female. And in a country like ours, where we hold up half the sky, it is important that we stand and hold our position. One of the most gratifying moments of my career, quite frankly, was the passage of the Affordable Care Act. Do you know what that is?
Yes.
Obamacare.
Yes.
Right? And what that did was it made it possible for all of us to be able to take care of our health. And that's important. You know, you have the potential to live longer than your parents will live, than your grandparents lived. And how do you go about doing that? Well, every year you have the ability to visit with a doctor, to do a checkup, to figure out how your body is working and what you can do to strengthen it along the way. That's very important because, you know, we can talk about being phenomenal, but when you're not feeling well, ain't nothing phenomenal about that. Right? Right?
Yes.
So if we know and we say on our birthday each year, we're going to make an appointment with the doctor just to check things out. It costs you nothing. But what you can learn from that is how you maintain your health, how you balance your diet if you need to. Because you'll find out, well, you know, I don't have enough iron. And iron is important in order for me to be strong, right? So what you do, you leave the doctor's office and you buy some spinach. Hello, somebody.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
You eat some kale.
Natural.
You begin to do things that help you to flourish. And when your body is intact, your mind is intact. You become creative. You become involved. You become activated. And so part of what my job to do was to make sure that everyone in our community could access health care. There's a study from the University of Maryland School of Public Health that found that the uninsured rate of African Americans decreased more than for any other group in the United States because of the Affordable Care Act. Can you imagine that? For so long, our community would only show up in the emergency room when we were ill, we were injured, and that was no way for us to be able to persevere in our society. So I'm proud that I worked with President Barack Obama to create the Affordable Care Act. And I'm fighting every day to defend that law because there's a new administration in town. Did y'all hear about that? Number 45? And number 45 wants to get rid of our health care. Can you imagine? You all should be saying shame.
Shame.
That was weak. Y'all should be saying shame.
Shame.
There you go. That's what I'm talking about. Because it is a shame. We should all be, as a nation, moving forward to make sure that we have as healthy a population as possible. Because we can lead the world in innovation. We can lead the world in our talent, our skill, and expertise, knowing we are healthy and able to stand up to anything that should come our way. But I'm not satisfied. I'm not satisfied with our concerns being ignored. And I'm not satisfied when African-American female college graduation rates remain significantly lower than other women. So when we heard from our previous speaker, she made it clear to us that we have everything we need within us and around us to support our academic growth and development. How many of you are willing and ready to take up that charge? Let me see your hands. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Because I am here right now looking for who the next congresswoman is going to be in this room. Looking for who the next entrepreneur that's going to start their own firm and hire people from our community is going to be in this room right now. Looking for the next crop of healthcare professionals that are going to take care of our people. That's why I'm here. I'm looking to see who you are right now. And it's not too early to look, open our eyes, to see each other, and to know that we have what it takes to make that happen. The STEM field. The STEM fields are so, so important. And I call it STEAM, because I think we need to add the arts into it. We need to raise up all of our talents. But that understanding of math and science is a key that unlocks so much potential, so much creativity. I told you, I didn't know about STEM when I was coming up, but I was just curious about science because I wanted to be a pediatrician. So I went through all of my education, even up to college, as a science major, knowing that learning those complex theories, breaking them down, making them fun, getting that discovery, clicking in my head, made it possible for me not only to do science, but to analyze the world around me, to be concerned about things like the Paris Agreement. Who knows about the Paris Agreement? Raise your hand. It's okay if you don't know. It's all right. The Paris Agreement was an agreement that President Obama entered into to talk about how the United States would remain a leader in combating climate change and global warming. Climate change and global warming. Isn't it cold outside? Mm-hmm. Isn't it chilly?
Yes.
It's June. Mm-hmm. Climate change. Who here is going to be the one to come up with the new technologies to protect our communities in a time of climate change? Mm-hmm. Who's going to come up with the new theories of how we reduce carbon in our output so that we don't destroy the environment? That's your job. Someone in this room is going to have the key.
Yes.
We want to encourage that. We want to lift you up. We want you to think creatively, because indeed the answer could be sitting here right next to you right now. Mm-hmm. And if you think it's not a problem, y'all remember Superstorm Sandy?
Yes.
Do you remember Superstorm Sandy? Do you know that that had never, ever happened before?
Yeah.
Never. But we know it can happen again. Mm-hmm. So many people had to move from their homes. So many people flooded out. And did you know that we all live on islands? New York City, with the exception of the Bronx, are islands. Manhattan Island, Brooklyn and Queens are on Long Island, right? Staten Island. Islands are susceptible to sea level rise, which is what is happening. And we don't know how it's all connected, but we should. Is connected because the polar ice caps are melting. And for thousands of years, they were frozen, stabilizing the environment we live in. Who is going to be the researcher who's going to determine how we build new technologies to shelter us from the rise in sea level? You're sitting right here, right now, Phenomenal girls.
Yes.
Phenomenal. And so I wanted to stop by just to share with you my enthusiasm for who you are, for what you're doing, for this gathering, and why I go to Washington each week to fight for you, to fight for opportunities for you to learn in school whatever it is that your heart desires, that you will have the resources, that community organizations like Canva and institutions like SUNY Downstate will continue to be able to deliver for you opportunities like this one to engage with each other so that we can build a stronger community. I'm not satisfied with the fact that people of African descent are the poorest group of people in the country. Lack of wealth, with single female-headed black households representing the largest portion of that group. You know, to be in the wealthiest country in the world and not be able to grab, to generate wealth that we can pass on from generation to generation is unspeakable. It's not that we don't have the brains, we don't have the ability, what we don't have are the opportunities. And as long as I'm flying back and forth between Brooklyn in Washington, D.C., each week, I'm going to be fighting for you to have the opportunity to generate wealth. Yes.
Phenomenal.
To generate wealth. Because we have given as much to the building of this country as each and every one of anyone else in this nation. So the Congressional Caucus on Black Women and Girls grew out of my dissatisfaction with the current state of affairs for black women and girls. The caucus was founded by myself, a woman named Bonnie Watson Coleman, Congresswoman Bonnie Watson Coleman. She's in New Jersey. She's the only black woman in the congressional delegation for New Jersey. And Congresswoman Robin Kelly, who is from Illinois, who happens to be the only black woman in the congressional delegation from Illinois. And we represent a critical opportunity for all of us. African American women and girls, this is the first caucus ever in the history of the United States Congress designed to make black women and girls a priority. More often than not, black girls and women are disproportionately affected by a multitude of socioeconomic issues that diminish our quality of life and threaten the well-being of our families and our communities. As a black woman, I know firsthand how important it is to have a voice in the policy-making process that frequently minimizes or altogether ignores the challenges that we all face. This caucus gives women and girls a chance to have a seat at the table and directly address the important issues of our community. And I want to hear from you girls. I want to know your experience. I told you, I grew up in the 60s, 70s, and 80s. Today, when I was coming up, we didn't have Facebook. We didn't have social media. We had to call each other on the phone before we left our house and meet up and figure out how we were going to conduct our lives. You guys can make things happen on the move. You have new technologies that are now that will help you to empower each other. When you leave here today, you should have a Google group. Hello?
Yes. Phenomenal.
Hello. You all should know each other, how each other is doing. You should know how to connect with me in my office. You should know how to connect with SUNY and Canva. So that if you have an issue, if you have a problem, you can call your big sisters and we'll roll up in that Canva.
Phenomenal.
Right?
Yes.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
That's Black girl magic.
Yes.
And we all have it. So the Congressional Caucus on Black Women and Girls is grounded in concrete and substantive policy ideas, establishing a foundation on which we can build an agenda and initiatives. And like I said, you all are part of that caucus. That was the, we created this just to connect with you. Our agenda and initiatives will focus on 5 issues vital to the success and growth. We're gonna be concentrating on education, economic empowerment, healthcare, criminal justice reform, and social justice. Each of these 3 chairs are responsible for at least 1 or 5 issue focuses. And I've taken on the issues areas of education and economic empowerment. In creating this caucus, we hope to address these issues on a broader scale and encourage our country to make the necessary changes needed to support you and your families in everything that you want to accomplish. Just like I'm not satisfied with the current state of affairs, you should not allow yourself to become satisfied either. What's happening right now with 45 is not normal. Don't get used to it. Be anxious about it. Feel a little stirring in your spirit so that your spirit is ready to push back to create the space where you will grow and you will flourish, where you will not feel like you're being victimized, but that you have the power to make the change. Can you do that?
Yes.
I can't hear you.
Yes.
Don't let me get an attitude up in here. Can you do that?
Yes.
I want to know that because when I go back to Washington, D.C., I want them to know that the Phenomenal Girls Symposium is ready to roll.
Yes.
Woo. Is ready to roll.
Yes.
All right. I just want to be sure. You should want the best in life. You should want the best that life has to offer you because you are strong, you are powerful, you have the potential, and you deserve the very best. The workshops that you will participate in today will give you the knowledge that you need to be healthy, think positively about yourself, avoid risky behaviors that may lead you down the wrong road in life. So let me share a little something with you real quick. When I went to high school, I hung out with the misfit crowd. I wasn't with the in crowd. I enjoyed, now, when I was coming up, that's when hip-hop first started. I enjoy hip-hop music. I love the dance. I love the roller skate. But I focused on my education. And so that, they labeled me a nerd. I don't care. Because a lot of folks who call me a nerd are having difficulties today, and look where I'm at.
Amen. Phenomenal.
Look where I'm at.
Phenomenal.
So don't let name calling shame you into not doing your best. Because oftentimes people who are discouraging you are discouraged themselves. You need to turn to that person and say, that's your issue, it's not mine. If you need some help, you better ask somebody. Hello?
Yes.
Hello?
Go get that help.
You are surrounded today by people who love and support you, who want to help you be the best that you can be. That is why I'm here today, to help and encourage you to do exactly that, and to hopefully inspire just a spark in you so that you will pursue your dreams. I'm someone who pursued her dream. While I started out in science, one of the things I always wanted to do was give back to my community. I'm one of the few people in Congress who represents the neighborhoods, the schools, the people that I was born and raised in. Most members of Congress represent areas where they went to college or they found their spouse. I came back home because I wanted to use my education to give back to other people, to serve other people. I love my community. Because this community gave me everything I needed to be successful. They supported me, they encouraged me, they sheltered me from harm. When kids were trying to call me a nerd, there was always someone there to congratulate me on my accomplishments. Balanced it out. Balanced it out. When I was acting a fool, walking down the street, there was always a neighbor to say, oh, I know your mother. And I straightened up right away. But this community did so much, so much. They planted in me the dreams and aspirations of those who had sacrificed so that we could sit here at SUNY Downstate today and have this symposium. So I'm confident that if each of you follow your dreams, you will do the same. I know it. There's nothing extra special about me other than the fact that I have a passion for what I do. If you can find that passion, whatever it is that you like to do, will be fulfilling in many ways, in helping you to generate wealth, knowledge, but you have to be passionate about it. Just remember, never consider anything out of your reach and always believe in yourself. That's why I started the Congressional Caucus on Black Women and Girls, is because I want you to have the best opportunities, the best lives that you can have. Being here today is your first step towards being your best. I want to thank you for allowing me to crash the party, because I wouldn't want to be anyplace else this morning but to be here to encourage each and every one of you, to let you know that out of sight is not out of mind. When I'm in Washington, D.C. each week, it's all of you that I'm thinking about, looking to find ways to create policies in the Congress, laws that will enable you to fulfill your dreams, to unleash your power, to make your contributions known to the world, that you are not hidden figures, that you are here, you are proud, you are strong, you are smart, you are determined, you have the ability, you have your backup crew, and you're gonna make it happen. So to each and every one of you today, thank you so very much for having me. Thank you so very much for showing up. And I hope that as you go through your workshops today, that not only will you show up, but that you will show out. Enjoy the rest of the day.